Hi, it's Mark from Top Local Lead Generation. We're here today talking with David Fairbairn of Fairbairn Inspections in Vancouver. And we're going to cover a very interesting topic, aluminum wiring. How are you doing today, David?
Hey, I'm good, Mark. You ready to talk about electrical safety?
Yeah, so I guess we're in a spot where we can actually see an electrical panel where you are today. So aluminum wiring, what year was aluminum wire sort of started to be installed in homes?
Yeah, okay, so just for today, we're actually looking at an electrical panel. Now, this house was built in the mid-80s. You're not going to find aluminum wiring in a house built in the 80s. Aluminum wiring was used from the mid-60s to the mid to late 70s. I've seen it as late as about 77 or 78. And here's the thing about it, is because it was manufactured and installed around those times, doesn't necessarily mean it stopped after the 70s. I've actually seen backstock of it used in unpermitted work. You know, sometimes there's an electrician, he's got a bunch of extra in his truck, and he's going to throw it in your panel. That's why you always have to check every single panel, even if it's from the mid-80s. I always pull them open, and once or twice, you know, you'll find old aluminum wiring. But the main thing is it was used from the mid-60s to mid-70s.
So why are we even concerned about aluminum wiring?
Well, we're concerned about aluminum wiring because it overheats. The draw with aluminum wiring was that it was cheap, and it's exactly as easy to install as copper was. As copper prices rose, we said, hey, you know, let's actually start using aluminum. It's a lot cheaper. You can wire up a whole house for a lot less than you can with copper. And what we discovered later, unfortunately, was that it overheats at connections. So aluminum has a very poor, it handles current very poorly, and it tends to overheat at places like you've got a switch, a light fixture, a junction box. Those are all areas that can actually, you can get an overheating condition. And it actually started fires. And the statistic was that a home wired with aluminum wiring is 44 times more likely to have an electrical fire than a house wired with copper. So you can see the statistical need to remediate aluminum wiring. And for that reason, let's say you're buying a house, you know, a Vancouver special built in the early 70s. You know, if you've got aluminum wiring, you're going to have a hard time getting insurance on that house. The insurance companies, understandably, don't want to see aluminum wiring in the house. And if they do see it, they want to see it corrected or the house rewired.
So how do you tell if you've got it in your house?
Okay, so what we're going to do is I'm going to pull up some photos of it because I want to show you what aluminum wiring looks like in a house. So let me know when you can see the photo here that I'm going to be bringing up.
Okay.
Okay, so here we are. We're looking at, this is a receptacle that's been pulled from the wall, and it's pretty easy to tell that you've got aluminum. Copper is sort of a shiny gold color, and aluminum is generally a silver color. So if you see this, you know, chances are you have aluminum. Now, in some older houses, particularly, you know, in a character home, you know, pre-1950, you will see what's called tin copper, where they would actually take the copper, put some solder onto the end of it, and what's called tinning. And that can actually confuse a lot of newer inspectors and newer electricians, where it actually looks like aluminum. The way to tell is that if you have a rubber jacket. So here we can see our black and white wires, the rubber jacketed. We also look at the time frame of the house. You know, this is from, I believe, a 70s house or early 70s house. And we can see that it's you know, if you look at the cut, the tips of the wire, you can see that it's aluminum all the way through. What we tried to do, or what they tried to do later, once aluminum had a bad reputation, we started bringing out a new type of material called copper-clad aluminum, or CCA. CCA was basically aluminum wiring with a copper coating on it, and it doesn't work. The idea was that we would get the conductivity of copper without the cost of it. It doesn't work, and if you see CCA, you pretty much have to remove it. I'm going to go to the next slide here. This is a panel from an inspection in Richmond. So this is a sort of a Vancouver special in the Richmond area. House was built in 72, and this is the best way to tell if you've got it. So we're pulling the panel open. We're having a look at the bottom there. You can see those white wires coming up and going into that bus bar. There's sort of a horizontal bar at the bottom. that's the best place to find aluminum. So I just want to outline that if you're getting a home inspection done, make sure your inspector is actually pulling the panel cover open. You cannot tell, usually, without pulling either some receptacles or the panel cover. Most home inspection standards do not require the inspector to actually open up the panel, which actually scares me because I think every panel should be open. It's a huge, huge area where you can have safety concerns. So we open this up. This has got aluminum in it. Here's the same house. We've got a receptacle here that has overheated. And you can, if you were to zoom in a little bit, it's not the best picture, but there are scorch marks actually on the wires. This actually was a serious fire risk, and the aluminum here was too far gone. They had to actually rewire the house, and that cost, I believe it was around $10,000 to $12,000 to rewire the whole house, and that's with all the drywall work. So this was a big find. Very important to pull a couple of receptacles if you do find aluminum wiring, because you want to see how it's actually performing and whether or not somebody's done something to it. And the last photo I'm going to show you here, this is a panel, again, from Richmond. This is actually a different house. And what we've used here is thermal imaging, and we're scanning the panel for overheating. And the red cursor in the middle is an automatic hot point sensor. It's going to find the hottest point in the panel. And if you look at the top left, that's running up. The camera actually gave up after about 270. That's what that star means. But it says it's higher. It's at least 270 degrees Celsius. This is when the stove was running. So we had the stove with all the burners on. And you got a bad connection in your breaker panel. So thermal imaging can really help us identify if the aluminum you have is an immediate safety risk or not.
So just to remind everybody, water boils at 100 degrees centigrade. So 270 is what we would call really, really hot and really, really unsafe. A high risk of a fire.
Right, yeah. Very high risk of a fire. Yeah, there's been, you know, anecdotally, I know several people who actually live in a house that's loaded with aluminum wiring, and it's not uncommon to have the outlet just, you know, you hear a pop sound, shorts out, and all of a sudden you got a big scorch mark next to your drywall. And drywall is, you know, combustible, and it's really scary stuff.
What about the electrical use from that much heat?
I would like to see a study done on it, but as far as I can tell, it's much more efficient not to have overheating going on. So if you have overheating in your electrical system, you know, my immediate concern would be that it would be extremely dangerous to live in a house that's overheating from, you know, a fire and safety standpoint. But then again, if you're converting electricity to heat, you're not converting electricity to the use that you want it, so you're wasting an enormous amount of power too. So it's just, you know, it's a bad deal all around.
So what is, if you find it, you do an inspection, you find it, it's not safe, what do people have to do about it?
So there's a couple of routes you can go. The most obvious route would be to rewire the house. And in many cases, if you don't have issues with your aluminum wiring, it's not really prudent to do that because there may not be a need. So the main thing is to get a certified licensed electrician out to review your electrical system. So as a home inspector and almost any inspector you'll find, if they find aluminum wiring, the first thing they're going to say is have an electrician who's familiar with this type of material in to review your electrical system. And they can tell you exactly what stage you're at. So that's the obvious thing, is to have an electrician come and review it. And at that point, you know, if like that one in Richmond, that system was so far gone, there was overheating everywhere, that they had to rewire the house. They had to pull the aluminum wires out, replace them with copper, and it was a huge job. The other option is what's called pigtailing. Now, pigtailing is a method where you can put a small piece of copper onto the end of the wire. So let's say I've got a receptacle, and we're going to actually take a small piece of copper wire, connect it to the existing aluminum with a special paste called an antioxidant paste, and that prevents oxidization of the aluminum. And you twist it together with a special wire nut, and then you send that into your switch. And you do that for your hot and your neutrals. Now, you can imagine the labor involved with going through your house. If you were to count the number of receptacles, switches, and lights in the room you're sitting in right now, and then multiply that by the number of rooms in your house, and then multiply that by the labor it would take an electrician to go through and do that. It's not uncommon for this to be, you know, between $1,500 to $3,000 to go and redo that all. So it gets extremely expensive, and generally, if a system's been pigtailed, the electrical the insurance company will be okay with that.
So what does that accomplish?
That reduces the chance of overheating at the connections. So, like I said, aluminum overheats at connections. It doesn't just overheat in the center of the wire. It actually overheats at the connection points. For instance, that first picture I showed you of the receptacle, where it's actually screwed down, that's where it's going to overheat because it tends to expand and contract as current passes through it, and it'll tug at that, and then you get oxidization and you get overheating going on. So by pigtailing, you're giving it more space to move. That's the big thing. And then you're also getting a good solid copper connection to the existing fixture. And the third thing you're getting is that antioxidant paste. So you're preventing oxidization of the aluminum. So that accomplishes everything that we want to, everything we don't like about aluminum, we can fix by pigtailing.
Does aluminum degrade with time? Is its current capability kind of degrade as it gets older and older?
I think more importantly, the chances of having an overheating condition increase over time. So it's not really a function of the material degrading. It's more that as you use a system for, let's say, 40 years, you've got a mid to late 60s house, it's loaded with bad aluminum. As you're using this over time, you're going to get the likelihood that you're going to have a failure at one of your junctions is going to be, it's just going to go up and up over time. It's a function of time. As I turn on a light, you've got, however many amps of current flowing through it, and it expands and contracts. And if it expands and contracts for 40 years, eventually it's going to give way. So it's not really a function of the material failing. It's just the sooner you can pigtail or get an electrician to correct it, the better. And the last thing I just want to point out is that there are some receptacles, fixtures, switches that were manufactured that say that they're stamped saying CUAL, and that basically means copper aluminum. So it's the idea was that it was a special fixture that would actually accommodate aluminum wiring and render it safe. And I'll let you guess if that worked or not. Spoiler: it didn't work. We tried a few things. We tried copper clad aluminum. That didn't work. We tried CUAL fixtures. That didn't work. So your only two options that are really feasible and what we see out in the field are pigtailing and rewiring your house. So you got to choose one of those two. In some very rare cases, the electrician will come in and say, you know what, this particular situation that you have here where it's all set up is actually in good shape, and I'm passing it. You know, here's a letter for your insurance company. I think I've heard of that every one time happening, so it's not very common. So call a certified electrician, have them check out your system, and make sure to get an inspector who's actually familiar with this type of material because it's a big deal.
So in having torn houses apart and found all kinds of electrical shenanigans, being kind,
having to take a word for it.
In say if somebody's redone their own basement or whatever, and maybe they've done some brilliant things like marrying copper and aluminum, just pigtailing it without the proper procedure.
I shouldn't have done with electrical tape. That was a good one.
Yeah, and or maybe just being crazy with junction boxes that are completely hidden, with all kinds of connection points, but using aluminum wire. Mm-hmm. Is there any way for you to actually spot that stuff?
We can't guarantee it, Mark. We can certainly do our best. What I do as part of my inspections, and I make sure this is, on this time period of house, is to find the oldest outlet in your house, oldest receptacle in your house. Let's say you open up your electrical panel, and you see copper all the way through, but you suspect they may have aluminum. It's right during the heyday of aluminum, and other houses in the neighborhood do have aluminum. And I see brand new copper wiring come in, I'm going to suspect that there's a splice box somewhere where somebody's actually hidden the aluminum wiring from view because they want to be dishonest about it. Now, most homeowners are honest. Once in a while, you'll get somebody trying to hide bad wiring, in which case you're going to want to find the oldest receptacle in the house, maybe a light switch or two, generally in the, you know, one of the upstairs bedrooms or bathrooms. You know, pull it open and have a look there. And that's happened to me one time, that somebody had actually hidden a splice box. It was actually pretty obvious from the panel. You know, we saw this brand new Lumex coming into the panel. You know, and it's, we're talking like a couple years old, and I'm going, okay, well, the house has either been rewired or they've just shunted in a bunch of copper into the panel. So that would be an area where we can't guarantee anything, but a good quality inspector knows what to look for would be able to hopefully find that.
And would this be a case where if it's that age of house where it's almost imperative that somebody gets a thermal imaging done of the house in case there are hidden junctions that are overheating?
Absolutely, yeah. I would recommend thermal imaging and as do it 100% of the time with certain types of scenarios, and aluminum wiring would be an area where I would always have an inspector who offers thermal imaging. The other time would be if you have a flat roof, because in Vancouver, flat roofs, there's no attic to inspect. So if you're going to get thermal imaging done, get it done when you have a flat roof or aluminum wiring, because that's where the thermal camera really shines, and we can uncover these problems that you can't see with your eyes. So aluminum wiring, definitely. Yeah, get thermal imaging. Have somebody scan the panel. You know, run it under load. Run a dryer. Run your oven and all your burners. You know, run the air conditioner all at the same time, you know, if you can. Find out what is going to happen when you move into that house and you're running all this stuff with your family in it. Find out how hot that panel gets. And that's what we can do with the thermal imaging camera. And that's what we did in Richmond and saved the customer a considerable amount of, well, you know, we may have saved them from a fire. Who knows? But, you know, certainly that's something that wouldn't have come up otherwise.
Great. So we've been talking about aluminum wiring and home inspections with Vancouver Home Inspector David Fairbairn of fairbairninspections.com. Give him a call at 604-395-2795 or go to his great website. Tons of information. He's very active on Facebook and Google Plus as well. Search him out. This is the guy you want to get doing your home inspection if you want to live safe. Plain and simple. Thanks, David.
Thanks, Mark. Talk to you soon.